to our special story for the day. It was her initial dream to wear a military officer's uniform, but that was dashed. Reason being, she had no formal education. So, Fidelia Adogo made a detour into a male-dominated area. She became a full-time barber. But that was not without initial disapproval from her family. Despite their frowning on her chosen profession, Fidelia persevered and convinced them to give in. Today, she stands tall as one of the few women in that field, and with an eye for style, she says the bills gets paid after a day of honest labor. GBC News shares the story of a woman barber at the Hong Kong taxi rank in Accra.
A barber for the past 10 years, Fidelia Adogo, a single mother of three, moved to Accra from the Volta region in search of proverbial greener pastures. She vowed to herself that nothing would stop her from chasing her dreams. She says the idea of becoming a barber was to enable her get into the military, which was suggested by a friend. She sold sachet water and fruits on the streets of Accra, among other money-making ventures, to help her buy a shop to start her barbering at Hong Kong taxi rank at Kwashimang. This is because getting into the military wasn't possible without education.
I don't have a helper. Like, sometimes it's difficult to me to eat at a work site. So my madam has given me 1 day to go and look for money. I get a little bit money and I go and do the barbering, because my friend tell me if I go to, I have a barbering certificate, I'll be able to go to military. That's why I went to learn the barbering. So after the barbering too, they say if you are not a secondary school, you won't go. So and that was the reason. That's why I came. My friend told me I can make it if I start working with this.
Every morning, she scavenges for empty sachets in her neighborhood for sale to supplement her income. Her clients are mixed. She cuts and braids hair for men, women, and children. Fidelia says even though the business has been successful, she faced and still faces some challenges as a female barber.
Sometimes it's difficult for me. To them, she understand that I can do it for them. When they came here, sometimes I'll be talking, I can do it. Sometimes to the moment they saw me, that they see that I'm a woman, they just left me. They go. Sometimes I'll be talking. Or sometimes when they see that I'm barbering somebody, that one day the person will have patience to wait for me to do it. Without that, they won't allow us.
Some of her clients told the news team that they were a bit skeptical about her skills till they tried her.
First, I was really surprised because I didn't know, like, anytime I pass by, she'll be doing the hair, I'll come just spy and be like, this woman, she a man, or like, she's a woman. So it's something you, even when you think of, you can't, I don't know if you know what to say, but trust me, she's very creative.
My sister told me I could work Panama, I could work Panama.
I really like the haircut my sister has done for me.
When I step,
I like the way she was able to fade the sides of my head.
Me a top a chia nina, I go me a fear charge, fear charge, and I feel I could work Panama.
Surprise me, you know, it's overwhelming, you know, say woman barbering, you know, in Ghana, you know, it's difficult. You can learn something. To become somebody.
A slow day for Fidelia means at least 5 to 10 haircuts, while on a good day, her clients list is countless. Her daughter Daniela Egbeku said she is always proud to see her mother giving a haircut.
I feel happy when she's even barbering someone, so it's a surprise thing for me that you see a woman barbering a man, even in a since I was born, she's the one barbering me when I was a little girl. I would tell people that everything that man can do, a woman too can do better. I want people should come to Accra, hear the Lord's Pentecostal, so that they should come and barber at my mom's place, so that my mom will get money to take care of me.
Fidelia says any help to expand her business is very welcome. She has her eye on a bigger shop to probably offer employment to some interested youth.
I wanted to do something to support myself and my children. So please, if somebody listen to me or somebody hearing me, I want to go far, so I need your support. Please, to make Ghana proud.
Fidelia has no intention of putting her scissors down permanently in this male-dominated field. She is happy to compete with the men and actually enjoy what she does, and it pays the bills. Her plan for the future includes satellite shops in Accra. Fidelia wants to be an inspiration to young girls and women and prove to them that determination is a wake-up call to the human will, and success is always possible for the person who refuses to give up.